St. Joseph's on Drummer here. A wet and windy for Sean. Referee checks his watches, we're nearly ready to go. At midfield for the throw-in is Deirdre Moore and Megan O'Rourke. And the ball's in and the game's on as Megan connects it for St. Joseph's. Gets it down the field. In it goes for Tanya. But it's Drummer here coming away with it. And it's the number 9. Sinead Fowley gives it up the field there towards the number 5 for Mairead McMorrow. Sinead Fowley has it. Lifts it off there to the number 15. Playing deep, rushing Fowley, captain of the Drumahair team. Being chased there by Dee Moran. As the rain pours down, a dangerous ball in. The hands go up. It's collected inside. She can't get it. And the number 14 referee blows the whistle and says there's a boot in there and it's a free out for St. Joseph's. Mary gives it out short towards the number 9. Sinead Fowley lets it off. But a good block there by Megan. And St. Joseph's trying to get through. Referee blows the whistle and it's a free in for St. Joseph's. This time it's going to be Broad O'Rourke to kick it. Rona now looking at the post. Here she comes with the kick. In it goes, it's high, and it's just the equaliser, it's over the bar. First score for St. Joseph's. In comes again. The number 13 it is this time. Aaron Farrell on the far side, number 10 has it. Idel Kelly for Drumahair. As they try to build again around the midfield area. On towards the 40 now, it's the number 13. Aaron Farrell for Drumahair fists it in to the corner. Over now again to the number 5, Idel Kelly. Gets the ball in to number 7 for Drumahair. Kick in. To 2 points for St. Joseph's. The free from Clare in it goes towards Megan O'Rourke, trying to get it up on the second attempt. It's very slippery and sticky out there. Still Megan gives it off. The referee blows the whistle and awards the free in to St. Joseph's. minutes 15 seconds gone here in the first half. It's 1-1 for Drumahair. It's 2 points for St. Joseph's. The free now from Rona O'Rourke for St. Joseph's. An awkward enough angle. It's tailing in nicely. Oh, lovely score. Over the bar goes. 14 and a half minutes gone in the first half. It's 4 points to 3 in favour of Drumahair. As Drumahair come building again on the far side, Mairead McMorrow, the number 5. Fist passes into the corner, forward from Dale Kelly. Two players inside. As Drumahair head towards the goals, and 14 inside now has it. Runs the trigger. That's the next second goal for Drumahair. Kick out now is from the shot, but Clare Owens are going to win it. For St. Joseph's, and back in again. She tries to pass it there towards Lorraine Moran, but it's Clare has it back herself. Into Dee Moran now inside. Dee now trying to get by a marker. Still Dee. Two of them. Gives it inside to Shannon O'Rourke. Back to Dee Moran. Pulls a trigger. Oh, the bar she goes. That's better. 4 points now for St. Joseph's. To 7 points for Drumahair. Goes to this one now as a free down. Brian O'Malley's free as she sees her. And it goes back to Vanessa again. It was Philippa, the goalkeeper coming for it now, and gives it out to Fionnuala Bohan on the far side. Down it goes towards Clare Owens. Clare now trying to get it on the second attempt. Back to Anya Heslin for St. Joseph's, trying to get away from her marker. On the far side, she lift-foots it down there towards Brona O'Rourke. Brona has it up. Trying to get away from her marker. Still Brona shoves her off, gives it into the corner. Towards Dee Moran. Dee is turning. One way now gone the other. Still Dee Moran heading for the goal. Pulls the trigger. Good score. Good score. That's over the bar. That's 5 now for St. Joseph's. It's 2 goals and 2 points. That's 8. There's 3 between them as we approach the half-time whistle. Lorraine Moran to take the free. Over it goes to Shannon O'Rourke. Fests it up there towards Grainne O'Malley for St. Joseph's now. We need to get it in here, a few scores. Still Grainne O'Malley gives it back to Shannon O'Rourke. It's Carmel McGovern out towards Claire Owens. Claire gives it to Michelle. Now Anya, it's back to Michelle. Looking at the goals, pulls the trigger. It's Dee Moore in there. Going to be a substitute on the Joseph team in a minute. The kick out comes out to Vanessa Gilogley from Philippa. Back up to Liam McGovern. Grania O'Malley makes herself available as Claire Owens goes for it close to the sideline. And Claire now on her bike, being chased by two Drummond Hare players. Great work, Claire, as Carmel McGovern comes forward. Carmel now turning, looking for the goals. Two of them around her. Back up to Anya Heslin as Lorraine's outside. Lorraine Morden now into Michelle Heslin. Take your point. Michelle pulls the trigger. Yep. And a bar. Great score by St. Joseph. Walked the whole way up the path. Great work by St. Joseph now. They're watching for the kick out. I believe the Philippa, but Philippa clears the line on the far side. It's going to be Shannon O'Rourke. To win it for St. Joseph. All out there on her own now. Coming by our marker. Hit hard as she comes out. It's a free up for St. Joseph. Down it goes now to Grania Malley. Grania now gives it off to Anya. Outside is Vanessa to Casilla. It's going to be Carmel McGovern now coming very strong first. Good work, Carmel. Vanessa now, get over you. Hit hard tackling. It's Vanessa in again. She has it now on the solo. Looking for options. Still Vanessa, get over you. Justin Joseph gives it to Carmel McGovern. Carmel's out there. Claire Owens, it's all on her own. But the pass has gone astray. Still Claire Owens. Claire now for St. Joseph's. Heading towards the goals. Gets by Sinead Fowley. In it goes towards Michelle. Pulls the trigger. And that's more like it. There's one between them again.
Referee checking his umpires. Dee Moore on midfield along with Megan O'Rourke for the throw-in. Ball's up on the final, replay is on. And it's number 11 for Drummond Hare. Anna Conlon getting it down into the middle there. Vanessa Gilogley with her, but it's collected by the Drummond Hare player. Back into number 15. Roisin Fowley, captain. Collected well there by Megan O'Rourke, given out to Grania Malley. Grania now gets it down. Louise Maguire back up to Shannon O'Rourke. Wearing a strapping today, gives it in to Dee Moore now for St. Joseph's. Dee is by our player now. In it goes in there to Michelle Heslin for St. Joseph's. Still Michelle lost it, but it's collected in there by Megan O'Rourke. Back out to Dee Moore. Dee looks at the post. Oh, it's just tailed out to the right and gone wide. The rain still coming down, but just not as heavy. Kick out now to Louise Maguire. Lets it out to Claire Owens. Claire does well there. Collected by Megan, back to Claire Owens again. Claire gets it in now to the forwards. Carmel McGovern collecting it well. Gives it to Dee Moore. Two of them round are still Dee. That's wins a free and a free in for St. Joseph's. And coming to kick it is Brona O'Rourke. 5.5 minutes gone here in Barnacoola. It's 2 points for Drummond Hare. No score yet for St. Joseph's. Hopefully this will be the opening one. Yes, looks good. And over the bar, straight over the black spot. A good score. Well done, Brona. Grania O'Malley is pushing up there. The semi on the far side, I see. Kick out coming now. But Claire Owens should get it. That's out for hands there to the number 13. Aaron Farrell wins it. She's fouled. Free down for Drummond Hare. Sinead Fowley makes the run there and collects it on the far side. Gets it down, but Fionnuala Bohan does well and wins it back for St. Joseph's. A low ball down now towards Brona. As Brona makes the run out, collects it well. Turns now on the lovely pass into Anya Heslin. Anya's away now, heading for the goals. Still Anya, gives it in to Carmel McGovern. Carmel now gives it out to Brona. Brona O'Rourke looking for options. Back to Claire Owens. as Karen McGovern's hit hard, but she gets away this time. Squatting through the whole lot, pulls a trigger. In a good, that's equaliser. Good work, St. Joseph's. 2 points for St. Joseph's, 2 points for Drumahair. Michelle going to kick it in there now. The hands go up. It's Carmel McGovern doing very well. Gives it in towards Claire Owen. She's pushed and it's a free in. This should be a point straight in front. Hopefully now it's... Here comes Brona now. And it goes straight over the black spot. Confidence. Very confident player, Brona. Free down for Joseph's. Taken quickly by Claire Owens into the corner towards Brona O'Rourke. Brona now. Getting by our player. Still on the solo run. Still Brona. Gives a nice ball in towards D, but it's over the heads. Ah, Carmel McGovern trying to get it back. On the ground, free in for Joseph's. Pop it over the bar, Brona again. To make it a 1 point game. Brona now getting into position. Here comes Brona, in it goes and over the bar. That's 4 now for St. Joseph's. It's 5 for Drumahair. Dee looks at the post now, she kicks it in, it's not going to make it. It's gone breaking to Brona. Brona pulls the trigger, over the bar. There's one between them. One between them now. 5 points for Joseph's, it's 6 for Drumahair. Now it's done. Mary Clancy now to kick it out. 4.5 minutes left. Out comes the kick out. Breaking ball. Claire Owens again. Elaine McGovern. Mish Anya Heslin. Out towards Brona. Brona now. Claire Owens is through. First St. Joseph's. Still Claire on the solo. Trying to get the player out of the way. Into Michelle. Pulls the trigger. That's the equaliser for Joseph's. It's 6 points for Joseph's. It's 6 for Drumahair. 28 minutes gone. The free from Michelle Heslin into Brona O'Rourke, but it, who's inside? Dee is trying to get her hands on it. She has it. She's pulled down. Free in. Is it a penalty? It's not inside, I don't think. 28 and a half minutes gone. This will be for Joseph to take the lead here now, if they can get ball over the bar. Hopefully Brona is going to kick it for the foul there on Dee Moore. Good work, St. Joseph's. Getting stronger now as the half goes on. In goes the kick from Brona over the bar. The lead for the first time today now. 7 for St. Joseph's, 6 points for Drumahair. And the kick out again with Mary Clancy. It's Dee Moore in midfield and Megan O'Rourke for the throw in. Nearly ready. Ball's up and the second half's on. And it's Dee Moore in there winning it for St. Joseph's. And it's a free down. Who's looking for it now? Dee kicks it down. Into the middle it goes towards Brona. Brona Rourke gives it off to Anya Heslin. Straight through the middle now like a knife through the butter. Pulls the trigger over the bar. Good start. 8 points now for St. Joseph's. It's 6 points for Drumahair. Here comes Michelle back into the action now. We're back to 15 versus 15 again as Dee Moore prepares to kick this free. So about 45 metres out. Straight in front of the goals. It looks good. It is good. It's over the bar now. And that's the lead again for St. Joseph's. It's 9 points for St. Joseph's. 8 minutes, 21 seconds gone here in the second half. It's 9 points for St. Joseph's. 8 for Drumahair. Michelle again. Back outside. Anya Heslin has it. Inside it comes out to Dee Moore. Ball off her leg. Gone out again. Claire Owens. Dee has it back. Get it out to Brona. Brona down on it now. Gives it out to Shannon. Back outside to Genevieve. Back outside again to Michelle. Michelle pulls the trigger. Deirdre's ball inside. Oh, it's a goal! It's a goal. It has to be a goal. Put up the flag. It is a goal. Back outside to Genevieve. Back outside again to Michelle. Michelle pulls the trigger. Deirdre's ball inside. Oh, it's a goal! It's a goal. It has to be a goal. Put up the flag. It is a goal. Has to be a goal. Has to be a goal. No doubt about it. Put up the flag. The referee, Jimmy, is going in to consult his umpires. But the umpire doing the points signal at the fellow with the green flag to put up the flag. So it has to be a goal. The ball was definitely over the line. Is he going for the green flag? He is. No, he's not. Ah, come on. Drumahair win it back. Back over there again, but Lorraine McGovern, but it's going to be Shannon O'Rourke collecting it for Joes. Down it goes towards Claire Owens now. Making ground for herself into Megan O'Rourke. Gives it off to Lorraine Moran this time. Lorraine's pass has gone astray. And it's Drumahair coming out with it again. Sinead Fowley. Referee blows the whistle. Overplayed it. Go quick at them. Put it over the bar. Into Genevieve Canning. Genevieve gives it to Louise. Oh, it's a good score. Louise Maguire. Fair play to Louise. They're having a great game. We played 24, 25 minutes. There's at least 5, 6, could be 7 minutes to go. Out comes the kick out from Mary Clancy, but Claire Owens is underneath it. Inside it goes to Brona. Brona's hidden. Pull the trigger. Oh, great score. Now we're 3 up. That's the score of the day for Brona O'Rourke. A beautiful point. And Drumahair coming out with it now, and Sinead Fowley. Up it comes. Dangerous ball. It's Anna Conlon with Fanula there as an amateur. That's Mairead McMurra now for Drumahair. Been chased by Lorraine Moran. Anna Conlon there. Still Lorraine Moran getting the hands in on her. Dangerous ball. Vanessa's in there. Oh, good work, Vanessa Galogli. Coming out and wins the free for St. Joseph's. Good work there, Josephs. It's still 11 points for St. Joseph's. It's 9 for Drumahair with 28 minutes, 20 seconds gone here. And it's going to be Philippa to kick this free.
Possession, keep possession.
Get it out. The free is taken to Fionnuala Bohan. For St. Joseph's, gets it down to Claire Owens. And the referee has blown the full-time whistle. I thought there was 2 minutes left. But it's all over, and St. Joseph's have won the championship. They're a second only championship. 2012 was the last time they won it down in Clune under lights. So congratulations to all the St. Joseph's players, team and management. Ball is up and the game is on. And breaking ball there, and the St. Joseph's have it. And down it goes into the forward line, but it's over the heads of the whole lot, and the keeper comes for it, the Blincar Manor keeper. She clears the line on the far side there. Still Lincar working it up there. There's a few switches on their team too. Around the middle now. Seems to be steps there, but referee says play on. Still the number 10 there for Lincar on the far side. It's Roisin Rooney had the ball. She goes down. There's a heavy collision there between, I think it's Alana Bohan. Player, and it's a free down for Joseph's. Quickly taken. Michelle and O'Rourke back to Louise Maguire again for St. Joseph's as she goes on the solo. Gives a nice hand pass into Celine Short now. Back to Anya Heslin for St. Joseph's. A lovely crossfield ball into Brona O'Rourke on the far side. Breeds the hop of the ball well. Where's Carmel? Carmel McGovern it is. Looks at the post. Shoots. And a good score and a good start for St. Joseph's. And it's going to be Claire is leaving it there for Vanessa Gilogli to take it. Six minutes gone here, 1 point for St. Joseph's, no score yet for Lincar Manor as Michelle Hessen gets the free down to Claire Owens all on her own now, heading on the far side towards the goals. Hand pass it in to Genevieve Canning, a young player on the team. Genevieve, as is Celine Short, very young. Back over to experienced player Anya Heslin. One of the twins.
Dee Morton now, another experienced player, heading for the goals. Down the middle she goes. She looks at the post. She pulls the trigger. And it's over the bar. That's the second point of the evening for St. Joseph's. This will hopefully make it three for St. Joseph's. Here comes Brona on the right. In it goes and over the bar. The third point of the evening for St. Joseph's it is. As the 18 minute goes up on the clock. Up she comes on the far side. Shannon O'Rourke wins it well for St. Joseph's. Gives it down there towards Kira Maguire. She's on the team now for Celine Short, who's gone off injured. Down it goes into the corner as Carmel makes the run towards it. Carmel wins it well. Getting by our marker. Looking for options. A lovely ball inside to Dee Moore. Keeper comes out. Dee collects it. Pulls the trigger. Goal for St. Joseph's. That's what we needed. Great work up the field by St. Joseph's all the way. That's more like it. One goal and three now for St. Joseph's. 23, heading off for 24 minutes gone here. 1-3 for St. Joseph's. 1 point for Lincar Manor as the kick. St. Joseph's, Brona O'Rourke, it's thankfully okay. Up to Kira Maguire. Back to Dee Moore again. Gets a lovely ball down into the corner towards Carmel again. Carmel McGovern playing very well from both sides this evening. She's dummied. She's gone on the right. Ball gone to ground. Two of them round her this time. But it's still Carmel looking for options. Still Carmel gives it over to Kira Maguire. Fists it in to Dee Morn, the goal scorer a minute ago. And a point. In goes Dee, pulls the trigger. Oh, lovely score by Dee Morn over the bar. That's more like it for St. Joseph's. 1-4 now for St. Joseph's. It's 1 point for Lincar Manor. Ideal conditions here in Parshawn and Carrick. The ball is up and the second half is on. And it's a high one and caught well there by Shannon O'Rourke. Gives it off to Michelle. It's Anya. Anya inside now. But well collected by the Lincar Manor Hamilton number 4. This comes a hand pass across to number 48. That's Efigil Martin. Out it comes to 23. It's Orlett Kelly. Inside now to Mirren Devaney. Attacked inside. Caught well, but foul on Vanessa Gilogli. And it'll be a hot ball. We'll resume the clock. 3 minutes, 6 seconds gone in the second half. It's 1-4 for St. Joseph's. No score yet in the second half for them. It's 2 points for Lincar as the sun is in her eyes now. The ball goes in. It's Kira Maguire getting the break. Pulls the trigger. Oh, it's in the back of the net. It's a goal for St. Joseph's. Yes. That's what we needed. 2 goals and 4 now for St. Joseph's. 2 points for Lincar Manor as the kick on the far side. Michelle Heston's with her. Gets the hand in. Now it's back to Aoife. The midfield, Aoife Gilmartin, she's fouled. It's a free down for Lincar Manor. 5 minutes, 21 seconds gone. A dangerous ball inside. The hands go up. Lincar have it. But it's Vanessa Gilogli trying to block it. A shot. A goal for Lincar Manor. Scored by the centre forward. Abby Glancy. Michelle Heslin wins it back for Joseph's. Gets it inside again. There's two of them in there. Flick it in. Kira is there. Nobody inside. Pull the trigger. Ah, it's in the back of the net again. Good work. 3 goals now and 4 for St. Joseph's. That's 13 points to 1 goal and 2, which is 5 for Lincar Manor. Goal and 3, that's 6 to 3 goals and 4, which is 13 for St. Joseph's. Ball gone to ground there as Anya gets the hand in, but it's the number 12. Leah Fox on the solo. Being chased there by Louise Maguire. In low towards the full centre forward. Abby Glancy put out wide by Shannon O'Rourke. She pulls the trigger, but it's going to tail out to the left and it's going to be a wide ball as Kira comes for it. Taps it down. But who's there? Can't have it. It's in the back of the net. In the back of the net. 2 goals and 3 this time for Lincar. The 3 goals and 4 for St. Joseph's. Get out of there. Gives it up to Shannon O'Rourke. Back to Dee Moore now. Up the field, we need to go with the ball. Gets a nice ball down now towards the forwards. It's Carmel McGovern. Wins it well. She needs support though. Who's with her? Still Carmel. Trying to get inside. Still Carmel McGovern. Looking for options. Gives it inside now. Genevieve. It's Brona O'Rourke. Pulls the trigger. A good score for St. Joseph's. Over the bar she goes. 13 minutes gone in the second half. It's 3 goals and 5 there on the far side, trying to get it up. She has it. Good work, Rachel. Dee Moore's looking for it. She gets it now on the run. She's gone. Still Dee. Turning back. Goes one way. Then goes the other. Gives a lovely pass in to Brona. Brona O'Rourke for St. Joseph's. Carmel McGovern. Crossfield ball, but you want a comfort. But it's won back by Dee Moore. Dee is pulling the trigger. She's looking for options. Gives it back there towards Anya Heslin. Still Anya on the attack. Down the middle she's gone. Still Anya Heslin for St. Joseph's. Wins one. Still Anya. Back into Dee. Dee now looking at the goals. Gives it back out. It's Michelle. Pulls the trigger. Here it goes and over the bar. Good score. A good score as we approach 16 minutes gone in the second half. That's 3 goals and 6. That's 15 points for St. Joseph's to 2 goals and 3 for Glencar Manor. As Claire Owens makes the run. On you now. Let it in. Big D is inside. Coming forward now. Breaking ball. It's Michelle. Michelle Heslin. Pulls the trigger. Over the bar she goes. Yes. A good score. St. Joseph's 26, nearly 27 as a kick out. Oh, well won by Carmel. It's Rob. This could be it. Carmel McGovern over the bar. Well done, Carmel. 27 minutes gone. It's 3 goals and 9 points for St. Joseph's. That's 18 points to 2 goals and 5, which is 11. And St. Joseph's have to kick out again. Hold on to the ball now. Claire Owens gives it to Dee Moore. Trying to get into the zone. Gives it back out to Anya Heslin. Anya now. All her own. Pulls the trigger again. A mighty ball inside. It's won by Brona. Brona's shot is blocked down inside as Dee makes a run again. The back coming over with the first Glencar Manor coming out. It's Rachel. She looks like steps, referee. They can't get anywhere. St. Joseph's making a wall in front of them. And I better resume my own clock. With 30 minutes gone, in it goes to Gary Owen. Who's underneath it? Kira. Kira is still there, trying to get a fist to it. But one back by Celine Short. But there was a tug of a jersey. It's going to be a free out for Glencar Manor. As we approach into injury time now, 30 minutes, second half. A Gary Owen again down, close to the sideline. The hands go up. It's won by 25 for Glencar Manor. Niamh Feely. In it goes into the corner towards the number 9. It's Aoife Gilmartin for Glencar Manor. St. Joseph's now, you want to just tighten up on everybody. The hands go in again. We're won back by Alana Bohan. That woman at centre-back had a great game today. And there goes the final whistle. And St. Joseph's have won their back-to-back championship on a scoreline of 3 goals and 9 points, which is 18 points for St. Joseph's, to 2 goals and 5 for Glencar Manor.
Nearly ready to go now. The 2019 final ball's up and the game's on. And Anya Heslin collects it for St. Joseph's from the break. And Shannon gives it down the middle towards her twin sister Michelle. Gone to ground. Referee says play on. Grainne O'Malley collects it. Gives it up to Carmel McGovern. Carmel on the solo now. Crossfield ball towards Anya Heslin. Anya dummies one way. In goes the other. Fists it back to Carmel again. Carmel now trying to get in. Tapping it into the corner towards Celine Short. Celine now for St. Joseph's gets it up and gives it back to Carmel McGovern once again for St. Joseph's. As Claire Owens comes out looking for it. Brona's trying to get it back, but it's Manna Hamilton cleaning it up there. They're number 2. Emma Feely, she's fouled. It's a free down. Referee blows the whistle and he says, take it back. You took it too quick or not from the right place. Out comes a kick out from St. Joseph's keeper. The first one for her, Kira Masterson. Out to Claire Owens on the far side. Claire fist passes now down to Grainne O'Malley. Back in the St. Joseph's team. After been out for a year or so and coming on as subs. She's making the start. It's Carmel over there now towards Anya. Gives it back to Grainne O'Malley again for St. Joseph's. She pulls the trigger. In it goes, and that's the equaliser. Scored after 3 minutes. It's 1 point for St. Joseph's, 1 point for Glencar. 12 and a half minutes gone. Still 3 points for Glencar Manor, 1 for St. Joseph's. And it's number 9, Michelle Heslin, to kick it for St. Joseph's on the far side. Sideline ball.
In it goes into the corner towards Celine Short. Celine wins it back, gives it out to Brian O'Malley. Aine's putting the hand up for her. She has it now, going on the solo, getting closer to the target. Well, the trick hour. In it goes, and that's the second point of the afternoon for St. Joseph's. That's better. It's two for St. Joseph's, but it's three for Manor Hamilton, and we have played a little over 13 minutes gone here in the first half. Out comes the kick out on the far side again from Natasha McElroy, but it's won by Guanya Malley back for St. Joseph's into Carmel McGovern. Carmel doing well now, getting in among two of them. Four gone to ground, gives it back towards Claire Owens. Claire gets away to Aine. Aine pulls the shot, and there's the equaliser, 3-3. That's better for St. Joseph's. And it's Kira Masterson kicking it out quickly to Shannon O'Rourke on the far side. Gets it down now towards Grania. Grania O'Malley getting a good bit of ball, gives it to Claire Owens. Down into the corner it goes towards Carmen McGovern, winning it well for St. Joseph's. Turns her man, her marker, and she's away. Still Carmen, low ball inside. It's Celine, gives it back to Aine. Aine pulls the trigger on the left, and it's over the bar. Lead for St. Joseph's for the first time today. 4 points for St. Joseph's, 3 points for Manor Hamilton. Claire looking for options now. Carmel makes a run and gets it between the two of them. Carmel McGovern now gives it in to Aine. Aine Heslin pulls the trigger. Oh, keeper saves it, but it's in there. Goal! Just what we needed at half time. It's in the back of the net. A goal for St. Joseph's. It's 1-4 for St. Joseph's. 4 points for Glencairn Manor. Carmel makes a run and gets it between the two of them. Carmel McGovern now gives it in to Aine. Aine Heslin pulls the trigger. Oh, keeper saves it, but it's in there. At half time, it's in the back of the net. A goal for St. Joseph's. It's 1-4 for St. Joseph's. 4 points for Glencairn Manor. Out it comes from Michelle to Shannon, back to Michelle again for St. Joseph's. 28 minutes, nearly 29 gone. Back to Shannon O'Rourke. Back out it comes. Michelle back over to Carmel McGovern. Carmel making inroads now, heading for the goals. Just passed it on to Aine Heslin. Aine pulls the trigger. In it goes, that's better, over the bar. Now lead by 4 points. Approaching half time with 29 minutes, 14 seconds gone. 4.5 minutes gone here in the second half. It's 1-5 for Joseph's, 5 for Manor Hamilton. And here comes Bron O'Rourke with the free. It's high, it's lobbing, it's hit the post, it's down. Celine Short has it, gives it out to Rachel, back to Aine. Aine pulls the trigger, over the bar she goes. It's a 4 point lead again for St. Joseph's. 1-6, 9 points to 5 for Glencairn Manor. Here comes Michelle now with a Gary Owen. Who's underneath it? It's the fullback, Cammy McPartlin, coming out with it. Fists it out to Mirren. Davani playing very deep for Glencairn Manor. And it's Manor Hamilton building now. And it's Mirren again on the solo. And it goes high in the air. But good work by Vanessa Galoni for St. Joseph's. Comes up by two of them. Gets it up now towards Rachel McIntyre on the far side. Rachel turns now on the solo. Coming towards her, Shannon O'Rourke playing well in the centre. Back position. Gives it over to Carmel McGovern. Is she away? She is. Three of them after. St. Carmel looking up. Coming across. Referee. That's a black card all day long. 15 plays, 14 on the free in now with Bron O'Rourke. With 7 minutes gone here in the second half. And 4 points up, 1-6 for St. Joseph's. Will this be 1-7? It looks good, it is good. It's 1-7 for St. Joseph's. 5 for Glencairn Manor. And the kick out now with Natasha McElroy on the far side. But it's Rachel again. McIntyre making a good solo. It's a nice pass in to Brona, into Celine Short, inside. Celine turns back, gives it out to Anya. Back over to Claire Owens. Loads of room. Back up to Elaine. Louise Maguire. Anya has it. Back out to Aileen Casey. Back out to Louise Maguire. For St. Joseph's. Claire Owens. Into Michelle. And a lovely score over the bar. Now we're going, yeah. Number 8. Good point for St. Joseph's, scored by Anya Heslin. 1-8 now for St. Joseph's. That's 11-5 from Anna Hamilton. Kira Masson kicks it out well on the far side. Elaine puts the hands up, McGovern, and fists it up towards Rachel McIntyre on her own. She's away on the solo now. Long ball down towards Carmel. Carmel gets it up. Heading for the goals. Two of them round her. Still Carmel McGovern. Holds the trigger. Over the bar. More like it. Michelle gives it in to Rachel. Rachel McAdear back to Michelle again. Back to Brona. Pulls the trigger. And it goes and it's turned out right and wide. And the manager's going bananas down here. Gordon. Out comes the kick out. It's going to be a sideline ball for Josephs. No, it hasn't gone out. It's gone down with like a hamstring put tear. It's Louise Maguire inside to Genevieve Canning. Back out to Anya Heslin pulling the trigger this time. Good point. 1-10, that's 13 points now for St. Joseph's to 7. 6 between them. Vanessa's tying the laces. She's up and she's ready again. And Kira makes the run. It's Louise Maguire waiting for it. Her shot's half blocked down, but Claire Owens is going to get it. Claire now, hand pass it up to Carmel McGovern. She's away again. Down the middle, Louise Maguire makes a run. Still Carmel, heading on a bike. Still Carmel McGovern. Rhoda makes a run inside. She has it now. Still Brona Rourke. Heading for the goals, gives it outside to Ray. Michelle, Rachel McAdear. Brona Rourke pulls the trigger. That's better over the bar, 2 goals. 11. 14 points for St. Joseph's to 7 from Anna Hamlin. 3 on the far side. Leone has it this time, trying to get by her marker. Gives it back to Carmel. And pass down the tray again, and Anna Hamlin have it. Roll in again. Crossfield ball coming towards it this time. Josses are down to 13 players. But have gone into injury time now. Dangerous ball inside. It's won by 13. Clancy again. Heading for the goals. Vanessa's in front of her. But it's tailed out for a 45. Woo! Certainly a grandstand finish here. 1-11 for St. Joseph's. It's 11 for Glencar Manor. 45 to be kicked by. See who's coming out to take it. Number wise, it's the number 13. Albert Lancy. Yeah. 31 minutes gone. Low ball inside. Caught by Claire Owens.
That's it. It's over.
There it is. It's all over. And St. Joseph's hang on to win the 3 in a row. And a scoreline of 1 goal and 11 to 11 points for Glencar Manor.
Havana, oh na na. Half of my heart is in Havana, oh na na. He took me back to East Atlanta, na na na. All of my heart is in Havana. There's something about his manners. Havana, oh na na. I can do it, but I can't.
Fresh out East Atlanta with no mountains down. Fresh out East Atlanta. Up like a traffic jam. Yeah. I was quick to pay that girl like Uncle Sam. Here you go, ayy. Take it on me. Ayy. Try the craving on me. Get the beating on me. On me. She waited on me. Yeah, well. Try the cake on me. Got the bacon on me. This is history in the making, homie. On me. Point blank, close range, that beat. If it goes a million, that's me. I was getting moolah, baby.
Havana, ooh, nah, nah. Hey.